I have a feeling you're getting cold feet.
Can you blame me? I mean, this is all messed up. None of this was supposed to happen.
Samir, you have to do this. No matter the outcome, I will still remain as your flatmate and friend.
I don't know. Can't we just pretend nothing happened?
As odd as it sounds coming from a demon, you must speak with her. It would haunt you otherwise.
In hindsight, maybe coming with me was a bad idea. She already isn't fond of you.
I can wait in the car if it's that troublesome. Watch the road, will you?
Sorry, it's just... I forgot to mention something.
All right. What did you neglect to tell me?
I was supposed to meet her family today. They're in town for a little while.
That does make this situation much more complicated.
Well, this is it. Geez, this is the worst time to be having anxiety.
Hello, my love. I hope you do not mind this being on so short notice. Thank you for coming.
Say it now. Say it before she has a chance to bring her parents in, then I can leave. Sure, no problem, Evra, but...
Oh, I should introduce you to my mother first.
Hold on a minute.
Mutter, come here.
No need to shout, Evra. And hello, you must be Samir?
Yes, I'm Samir. It's good to meet you. Did I seriously just shake her hand?
In this family, we hook. Please, have a seat, Samir. My husband will be in shortly. You will have to forgive his tardiness. He was called in to work this morning.
Actually, I can't stay. Not a problem at all. May I also say that the smell from the kitchen is delicious? Ugh, that was not what I meant.
It seems Mutter likes you.
That's wonderful. She didn't have to go through the trouble of cooking us lunch.
Are you kidding? Her cooking is like a small piece of heaven. But besides that, does this not feel used right? It finally feels like a for sure thing.
Listen, Evra. Before your dad gets back, I have to tell you something.
Anything, my love? What is wrong?
It's now or never. Well, to make a long story short. New Year's Eve, a few nights ago.
This is exactly why I keep coming back for more.
Gome, you are plastered. Calm down.
I keep coming back cause I must be a masochist.
Let's just turn on the TV, okay?
Gome, the masochistic demon.
Dude, I'm gonna get you some coffee. Man, it's like 4 in the morning. Dude, go sit back down.
I don't want coffee.
You'll sober up quicker with it.
Volo tea?
More Latin?
Et amus in cubiculum. Get game.
Did you just call me something rude? Man, my head. What? And that's it.
That is it? That is it. Samir, please tell me this is a sick joke.
It isn't. I kept trying to tell you earlier, but you wouldn't let me.
You could not have told me sooner. You could not have called me yesterday, or the morning of the disaster.
Look, we can move on from this. I wanted to wait to tell you in person, mostly because I know we can fix this.
You are joking. You think I want anything to do with you after you've been with another man?
It was a mistake.
You are disgusting, Samir. You are not the person he thought you were. Although he had feared for you after Gummy admitted his feelings for you, he knew in my heart that you were not that sort of man.
Everett.
He was wrong. You are a sick person to do such a thing and think that you would gain forgiveness. After the trust he put in you and after introducing you to my mother.
Ever, this doesn't have to be the end. I was drunk and so was he. It won't happen again. We won't drink together alone anymore.
Oh, and if you did drink alone with him you would do the same again? Is that what you are telling me? That you would prefer to be unnatural?
There's nothing wrong with people being gay. I am definitely not and I don't even know for sure if Gomez, but there's nothing unnatural about it.
You dare to defend it even now? Please leave. I do not wish for my father to meet you.
Ever, please. I do love you and I always have. Please don't leave me because of one mistake.
Get out.
Goma ditched me too? Wake up.
You don't have to shout at me. You were taking a long time, I got bored, and I took a nap.
I don't even know what I want to say right now. I want to turn to you in the worst way.
I take it that it did not go well.
I'm not talking to you while you're in the back seat.
Better?
Are you always destined to screw up my life? Honestly, I'm beginning to think you're just bad luck. You can't even fix anything right.
Hey, you didn't push me away.
I was drunk. I didn't know any better.
Don't blame your frail human constitution on me.
Listen to yourself. Are you seriously victim blaming me?
Oh dear lord in hell, Samir. We were both drunk. I am not victim blaming. Please don't do this. You're being ridiculous.
I just lost my first real girlfriend because of you. Because your constitution is weaker than mine.
Here we go. Get a hold of yourself. We're going for a drink. In public.
A drink? Are you serious? That should be the last thing on your mind after what happened.
Samir, I said in public. And it is only to ease the momentary pain you were going through. I also find myself needing to drown out my frustrations with myself.
Now you just sound like an alcoholic.
It doesn't matter. All I seem to do is screw everything up, even when I am trying to help. My intentions are good, Samir, but maybe you are right. Maybe I'm bad luck.
Damn it. I didn't mean.
Get driving. I'm sure Everett doesn't want you in this parking lot for longer than you need to be.
Everett.
Oh my goodness, let's go.
Samir. Samir, I've left you alone, but you're forgetting that a locked door will not keep me from you if I so will it.
Go away.
That's it. I'm coming in.
What in the hell have you done to yourself?
What do you mean? I look the same as always.
You've been lying in here for a few days now. I've given you your time to grieve, but honestly, you need to get out of this room.
She won't text me back. I told her I couldn't live without her or do anything worth living for as long as she ignored me. She still didn't text me back.
That is deplorable. Don't you dare put that on her shoulders. I am sorry that things have come to this, but both you and I screwed up.
You.
Excuse me?
You screwed this up. You screwed everything up again, didn't you? This was your plan all along. I gotta admit that it was well crafted and really well thought out.
Samir. I am trying to do the right thing here. Now get your ass out of bed and fix yourself up. You haven't eaten in 2 days.
Why? Just so I can go back to a life of being alone and being betrayed by someone who I thought was my best friend?
Samir, if I truly wanted to hurt you, I'd have been upfront about my intentions to do so. Was I not last time?
I don't know. Demons are crafty evil sons of.
Stop feeling sorry for yourself and get up and fix this. I've gone through the trouble of making you lunch, so force yourself downstairs to at least prevent your own death via starvation.
I guess. What have I got to lose anymore, anyway?
Your income. You haven't uploaded to your YouTube channel in a few days.
Oh well.
Stand. Get yourself together, man. You're eating and then we've got things to do.
I want to go back to bed.
No, you're going to buy Eva a gift and then you're going to deliver it to her in person.
She hates me. She already called me disgusting.
I'd speak with her myself, but I highly doubt that would be effective, which is why you're going to tell her that I've moved out.
You're not really moving, are you?
What? Just a bit ago you said you didn't trust me.
Ugh, I'm so confused.
Okay, stop crying. Maybe it was too soon, but at least I got you out of the apartment.
And? You got me to eat, I guess.
If you call a few bites eating, you're going to have more to worry about than being depressed over Evra in another day or so, namely your personal connection with the floor when you finally pass out from malnourishment. Lovely, people are starting to stare. Come, let's go. Let's just take this one step at a time, alright? You'll get her back.
Can't you do some weird demon voodoo magic to make her love me again?
Okay, one, it's dark magic. Not voodoo. Two, I wouldn't do it that way even if I could. I can't make a human love another without serious repercussions for the other person. Perhaps things will turn around. Check your phone.
She said she left something for me at the apartment. She must have stopped by while we were gone.
Good. Hopefully this is the start of a turn in the right direction. I promise I won't meddle with you two any longer. Not that I'd ever meant to.
Okay. Let's start over from today then. Everyone will.
Well, this must be the gift she left. Don't tell me she had access to your apartment this whole time.
I gave her a key shortly before you left around the holidays.
Well, you'd best get it back. It seems like you've dodged a bullet in this case.
She would have never done this if she wasn't angry with me.
No sane person would do this even if they were beyond livid. The fact that she supposedly loved you but then had the gall to destroy your personal possessions so easily is really telling of her character.
She always did seem a bit harsh with her personality.
Samir, leave this to me. I feel I started this by getting you two together, and then screwing it all up when you were so happy. At least you know her true colors now and you can begin to heal faster. I won't bother you about seeking her out any longer.
All right. Jeez. She spray painted the walls.
Gays go to hell, he's Sodom and Gomorrah. What a message to leave, and a misinformed one at that.
What do you mean?
If anyone actually read the Bible, they'd know Sodom and Gomorrah had nothing to do with being gay. Often a misquoted chapter.
Now isn't the time to get all religious studies on me. I need to go try to eat something.
Hopefully she left the key somewhere, and brace yourself for the kitchen just in case. I'll tidy up here.
Thanks, buddy. Thank goodness. The kitchen is untouched. She was even kind enough to leave the key with a note. I don't even want to know what it says. Where am I? I thought I was watching television.
Well then, hello, Samir.
Did you drag me here?
I wish you'd have told me sooner.
Told you what exactly? What is going on, Gome? Please don't do that. What in the hell was that?
Achoo!
She's really cute, and she liked me. Time to get back on track.
Achoo!
Breakfast.
Oh, you seem to have come down with a cold. This the season, I suppose.
It'll pass soon enough. But something more positive, I started getting on my dating profile again.
Ah, you're dating again? So soon?
Yeah. After seeing how horrible Ever was, I got over her pretty quick. After seeing her true nature, I realized that she wasn't someone I'd have hung around anyway.
You've got other more important things to focus on, you know?
Like, I've got my YouTube channel back up to date, and besides doing recordings every day, I'd say I got important covered.
I just think it's too soon, is all. I'd hate for the next girl to be your rebound from Ivra.
Dude, it won't be. I'm going to take more time to get to know someone from now on.
For now, just focus on getting better, alright?
Why are you so irritable?
Because I know what's best for you more than you do sometimes.
We've been over this. I'm not something to be controlled. But thanks for breakfast. I have a video to record.
But you're ill.
I'll be fine. A cold is nothing.
Ugh. Sure. A cold is nothing, I said.
Your voice is almost as deep as mine.
All right, rub it in.
I'm not doing that. You're most likely so sick because your depression lowered your immune system, and with as cold as it's been, add on the stress.
Don't remind me. I'm trying to recover, not...
Achoo!
Focus on the bad things. Besides, as soon as I get better, I may have a day to go on.
I thought we discussed the fact that you were going to get to know someone better before dating them formally.
You can date someone and not be serious. Why have you been getting so irritated with that lately?
I just want what's best for you. Rushing into things is not.
Oh hell, are you jealous?
No, Samir. I am not.
Lies.
Look, if you're going to tease me, then you can be sick by yourself.
Geez, sensitive much?
This? Gome, are you controlling my dreams again?
Are you sure you haven't gone completely bonkers? We came out here to get away from everything. Unless you meant it is a compliment, as in everything is just too damn good to not be a dream.
Did we? I thought I was sick.
Sick with infatuation, maybe.
No, wait a minute. Stop it.
What's gotten into you? Maybe I can help you feel better.
How?
Geez. What is with these dreams?
Not this again.
What did you say we were going to see?
Well, since your profile said you were interested in vampires and horror, I got us tickets to see Dracula.
Oh, as a play, at that. Wonderful, I've not had the chance to see it like this.
I'm glad you're happy. Let's head inside before it gets too crowded. I guess we underdressed a bit.
It's no big deal. It's not like anyone is paying attention to us.
You're right.
Oops. Better turn that off unless you want to become a theater goer's first enemy.
Sorry.
Oh, it's beginning. I'm so excited. I had a really good time, Samir.
I did too. I'm glad I guessed right on the show tonight.
You definitely are a charmer, that's for sure. You pay attention to more than just a girl's looks, which is A+ in my book.
So, Want to grab a coffee?
I'd love to, but I really should get back home. I have work early in the morning. I don't have the convenience of setting my own schedule like you do. Lucky duck.
Okay, well, it's good night then.
Good night, Samir.
Wow. She's intelligent, mature, and seems to be pretty sane. Oh geez. My phone's been buzzing all night.
So he is alive after all.
I had a sneaking suspicion it was you.
Who else would it be? You used to be such a shut-in that no one really ever rang you.
Hey, my mom called me sometimes.
I suppose you do fit the stereotype.
What stereotype?
Where have you been? Don't tell me you decided to be social.
I had a date, actually. Sorry I didn't tell you.
A date? Really?
Yeah. I'll tell you about it when I get home. I'm almost there. She was awesome, Gome. A big improvement over the last time.
Oh really? Rushing things a bit, aren't you?
Nah, this one feels right. She's mature, really pretty, has an accent to die for.
What accent is that?
She's Irish.
You have a thing for accents, don't you?
Wait a minute. Where are you going with this?
Nowhere at all. I made dinner, but it's in the fridge. I'll speak with you again tomorrow. Oh, and nice outfit, by the way. Inspired look.
I really don't know what you're talking about.
Good night, Samir.
What is his deal sometimes? Doesn't he realize that if you really love something, you should just let it go? Wait.
What have I become? A joke of a creature set out for total emotional destruction. What have you done to me? This is all your fault. My heart is under physical assault.
You're living in a dream. Get over yourself.
Despite the ones you're having.
Ugh.
What am I to do? Every time you see a new girl, I think we're through. You're always so flaky, it doesn't even matter. What's more important is who you're trying to flatter. Do you even love her? No, it can't be true.
Listen, I mean you no harm. I understand you love her, boy, but that man is a charm. Perhaps there's a wager, before we're through? I can compromise if you let me trust you.
What could you two be planning? Where am I in any of this? Don't take my feelings lightly. I'm about to get pissed. You're not in control of me. You can't always have your way.
Oh, be quiet, you damn Irumabo Rustike.
Everyone move aside, for Sinead is here. All I ask is that you lend me your ear. Now I know love when I see it's true, so stop fooling yourself. He's gotten to you.
No. You're misunderstanding. I really need to stop eating weird things before bed. Breakfast.
Didn't sleep well?
No. I keep having weird dreams. Maybe it's what I'm eating before bed.
Perhaps singing in your sleep is enough to leave you restless?
What? Excuse me? Come again?
I just meant to say that I could hear you out in the hallway.
Gome.
All right, so I watch you sleep sometimes.
That is, not what I was implying, but that is really creepy, dude.
Oh dear, The mail is here. I'll get it for you.
Hey, you're not escaping. He's going to drive me insane one day. That's odd. Usually Goma has breakfast ready and is at my bedroom door way earlier than this. Oh, there you are. What were you doing?
Just reading, until you interrupted me.
Okay. So, no wake-up call or breakfast?
I'm not your servant, Samir. If you'd like one of those, perhaps you should hire a maid.
Geez, no need to get snappy, dude. You've been doing it every day for a while now and it was odd as all. Everything okay?
Everything is fine, Samir. I have things to do today, however, so I must cut this conversation short.
What could you possibly have to do that's so pressing? Most of the time you're hanging out here playing video games.
Seriously, Samir. You've likened me to a lazy and boring existence.
Well, whenever I go out you always ring my phone off the hook, so I figured you don't really have much better to do.
I've got a life outside you. How do you know I haven't been dating someone, myself?
Wait, you're dating? Since when? Why didn't you tell me?
You've been so busy with your head up your new girlfriend's ass that I decided it was time to get a life of my own.
Right. So is it a guy?
You're assuming I prefer men just because I liked you?
Liked? What, you don't like me anymore?
You have a girlfriend and you've made it apparent that you are straight, despite the night we spent together on New Year's Eve.
Stop throwing that at me. I wasn't in my right mind and you kind of pressured me.
Oh, that's rich. I pressured you. You were quite willing. At least, your actions made it seem so.
Whatever, Goma. Do what you want. You're right. New Year's Eve was a mistake, and it doesn't even matter anyway.
A mistake? You feel it was a mistake?
Don't get all puppy-eyed on me. You've really been pissing me off lately with your over-possessive crap. Why don't you just go spend time with your boyfriend or girlfriend? Or whatever, and I'll do the same.
I had planned on it.
So who is it, anyway?
Why do you care?
Because I'm just curious. You always had to know about my dates.
You worry about yours and I'll worry about mine. Of whom I'm meeting in another hour.
I'm done playing your stupid games.
Who's the one playing games now?
Sorry I got called into work so early today. Everything's finished up now and I'll be right with you as soon as I change.
Take your time, Shanae.
Alright. Just a tick. Thank you for being such a sweetheart. You remembered my birthday.
Of course. How could I forget? Please, pick out anything you like.
You know, there is definitely something about you, Samir. I think you're a keeper.
Likewise.
I'm going to try some things on.
You know, I think I remember you.
Yes, we've met before. I came in here last year to buy some new outfits.
Oh, yes. You were here with your boyfriend.
He isn't my.
And I see you two are still together.
Excuse me?
Samir.
Goma. What are you doing here?
I was out shopping.
I thought you had a date.
I do. They're just not here at the moment. I was going to surprise them with something.
Right. Okay. Yeah. Sure.
Samir, what do you think about this one for our next date?
Well, this is awkward.
Oh, is that a friend of yours? You should introduce us.
Oh boy. Shanae, this is Goma, my roommate. Goma, this is.
Oh my, was he in a hurry?
No, he's just rude.
Oh, well, I believe this dress is my favorite so far.
It's yours. Unfortunately, we have to get going because I made reservations at a restaurant nearby for your birthday dinner.
Oh Samir, you know how to treat a girl.
I shouldn't even be doing this. I actually did it. Samir, your passwords are terribly easy to guess. Interesting. His dating profile was still up on his browser. I thought he was dating that woman. Oh, Samir, what have you been hiding from me? He should be getting back rather soon, if his schedule is correct. And there it is.
Man, I'm beat.
Welcome home, lover boy.
Gome, I didn't expect you to be in here.
What are you playing at, Samir?
What?
That poor girl. Have you told her? Or are you still in denial of it all? Perhaps you haven't experimented enough.
Told her what? What are you talking about?
Cut the shit, Samir. I'm a demon. I figure things out eventually. I know your secret.
I don't have any secrets. Is this another trick you're trying to play on me? Why can't you just leave me and my dating life alone?
Because I think Curious Sims's 10 has a different answer.
Wait, how did you find that screen name?
I told you, I'm a demon. I have my ways of finding things out.
Did you root through my computer?
Out with it, Curious Sims's.
That's a serious breach of the roommate code.
Grindr, Samir. What are you doing on Grindr?
I was looking for something for a friend.
Something that required you to create a screen name and speak to several people, as well as planning possible encounters? What are you doing, Samir?
It's your fault, you know. I would have never thought about it if you'd never pressured me on New Year's.
We've been over this. I most definitely did not pressure you, and if you continue to accuse me, you're going to see what a demon really looks like.
Why do you have to come back? Why do you keep messing with my life?
Why am I responsible for your confusion and your own decisions? Those are the real questions.
I feel lost. Ever was my first real girlfriend, and now that I actually care about myself more than I ever really have, thanks to you of course, I'm realizing that there's a whole different side to me that I'm not really sure about.
So you think you're gay?
No, I still like girls.
This is perfect.
It's not funny.
It's quite hilarious. A human getting bent all out of shape over who they may or may not be attracted to. You do realize that is the most trivial part of your existence.
It's not trivial to me. It's confusing, and you're the cause of that confusion.
So the new outfit was just a pleasant reminder?
What is that supposed to even mean?
Good night, Curious Sims's 10.
Stay off my computer. Oh great. The perfect time to get a text from Shanae.
Take the sunglasses off. You're not fooling anyone.
I don't want Shanae to see me if she's out or something.
If she's that into you, she won't be fooled. Besides, it's not like anyone knows anything but us.
I'm not taking chances. Hey, give those back.
We were going to have a conversation in the safety of a public place. Since you're so paranoid about me.
What should I do? Wait, no, don't answer that question. I know what you'll say.
Am I that obvious?
Seriously, Gome, I'm at a loss.
This would have been a lot easier if you'd just been honest with yourself from the beginning.
I don't want to lose Shanae, but at the same time, I...
You?
I'm not admitting anything here. So don't take my words out of context.
You what, Samir?
I just want to see what it would be like.
What is this, it, you are referring to?
Don't be an idiot. You know. You. Me.
Oh, I know. I just wanted to hear you say it.
Why am I even remotely attracted to you? You're an ass.
You're attracted to me.
I might be. Don't run with that, though. There will be boundaries.
Yes, yes, boundaries. Understood.
I mean it. This doesn't give you instant access to my everything.
Oh, this gives me wonderful ideas for your morning wake-up calls.
Stop. Stop that line of thought right there. You're jumping the gun. Besides, if you try that, I'll just slap you.
I can compromise.
Oh boy. This was a mistake.
Samir, I'm only joking. You know I have to give you a hard time.
So anyway, Shanae is at work all day. Fridays are kind of busy for her, so what do you want to do?
You know, I realize I'm a demon and I shouldn't have any sort of morals when it comes to this sort of thing, but what are you going to do about her during this experiment?
I don't know. We're just dating, so I'll make a decision when I'm sure.
All right, but you must be ready for the possibility of her finding out. I've not met her, so I really don't know her temperament, but she may not take too kindly to you messing around with someone else.
There is no messing around going on here. We're just hanging out. More often than we usually do.
Okay, Samir.
No. You're not allowed to seduce me with that ridiculously attractive laugh.
It's not like I have control over the way I laugh.
Whatever. Let's get out of here.
Who in the world is that? And how did she get my number?
I thought you said we weren't to go drinking together.
Does it really matter now?
Look at you. How much was your tab?
It was something.
Well, let's get you home. You'll do best with a bit of coffee and some rest.
And breakfast in bed?
You're loaded. Come on, we're getting you to bed.
Your nickname should be Mixed Signals.
I won't have you blaming another drunken night on me. Now come on.
Oh jeez, my head. That didn't help matters.
You look awful.
Gee, thanks.
Are you feeling well enough to eat?
Yeah, I think so. Just a headache.
Good. Got breakfast ready for you downstairs.
You know, I miss you taking care of me like this.
You probably are aware by now that a demon's jealousy can be a hell of a thing to be a victim of.
I deserve literally none of that, you know.
Then accept my apology. I'll meet you downstairs.
Wait. So you're actually not going to be a creep with all of this?
That's a bit harsh, but no. I told you I was teasing you.
Meet you downstairs.
I'm starting to wonder who is more befitting of the title of demon here.
Sorry, Samir. I haven't been getting much sleep. The start of spring brings in all kinds of cases at the hospital.
It's okay. It's why I came with you today so you didn't have to drive.
Oh, I see. So you didn't come just to see my pretty little face?
You know that's always a bonus. Besides, I get to meet your little sister.
Yes, she should be out soon. Practice must have run over.
I got my videos recorded this morning and ready to go up at the tap of my finger here, so I have as much time as you need.
Thank you, Samir. Oh, that reminds me. I got a strange text the other day from someone in regards to you.
Really? A mutual friend?
Some girl named Evra. Do you know her?
Oh god. Is she being the creepy stalker ex-girlfriend? I am so sorry, Shanae.
She seems to think something is going on between you and your roommate, Komei, was it?
Oh man, of course Evra would get all messed up about that. Listen, she's just bitter and trying to create problems. Komei is my roommate and friend and nothing more.
All right, no need to worry. I've been on dating websites and dated people off of them long enough to know what a crazy ex is like.
Seriously? She destroyed my apartment after I trusted her with a key around the holidays. When I got back from her house the day she broke up with me, everything was trashed.
My goodness. What happened?
Hey, I think that's your sister. She's waving at us.
Oh, yes, it's her. Be prepared. She's trying to steal any man I've ever tried to date.
I don't think I'm worried. 16 is a bit young for me. What am I even doing right now? Fooling myself? I'm a terrible person. I just lied to Shanae through my freaking teeth. I really don't want to go home. No. Definitely not going home. Why can't everything just stop for a minute? Give me a break? Or maybe I'm overworking myself while trying to juggle two people, only one of which I've been entirely honest.
What are you doing all the way out here?
I didn't want to be anywhere, really.
Samir, what's wrong?
Do you really have to ask that question?
How did today go?
It was all right, I guess. I met Shanae's sister. Drove them home from practice, and hung out with them a bit at Shanae's apartment.
You don't look too happy about this.
Because you kept coming up. Ever must have found out about everything somehow. I'm getting creepy stalker vibes.
Oh my, so she's trying to destroy everything you have now. Your personal possessions weren't enough.
Is she wrong though? Isn't this kind of cheating?
You said it yourself, you're just experimenting. As far as I'm concerned, I'm letting you have control over the whole thing.
You? Letting someone else have control?
I am capable of being decent on occasion. Don't spoil it.
Man. Ugh.
What now?
You ever just want to scream?
Not really, although since getting involved in your life in any manner I can see the appeal.
Hey, you made the decision to mess with me.
And then you pulled out that clever little exorcism. And the rest is history. Sounds like a horrible romance B-movie plotline.
You have to admit, that was kind of awesome how I came up with that.
You just used your brain, which is something not a lot of people do. I simply underestimated the human race. At least, I underestimated you.
So demons aren't all powerful and scary like we're led to believe. I think you're more like humans than you'll admit.
I could probably go for a bit of that screaming about now. What?
Did that just come out of you?
I believe we discussed the part about me being a demon.
I honestly forget sometimes because of how human you can be. That wasn't an insult. I remember back when you were all creepy tricks, sneaking into my dreams to screw with my head and ruin my entire life. I keep thinking you're doing the same thing still. But it's different. It's not malicious, it's just more of a benign pain in the ass than anything.
Make me sound like a damn tumor, why don't you?
Let's go home. You probably have dinner ready too, don't you?
Yes, your personal maid has slaved away for a few hours to be sure you don't die of starvation.
All right, geez.
And I do it for nothing.
Which I appreciate.
I do it for nothing.
Is that a good enough of a nothing for you?
Let's get going.
This has got to be the most ironic moment ever in my life.
Samir, what are you doing? We're ready.
Oh, he's probably just being his mopey self. I really wish I knew why he was so down when the weather is so beautiful.
Samir is Samir. He'll find a reason to have drama somewhere.
Right you are. You know, I'm glad he is a friend like you. You keep him on his toes as much as I do.
Yes. Friend.
When did it get this mixed up? How long has it even been? A few months previous.
Oh, I absolutely love markets like this. Thank you for bringing me. Next time we should invite your roommate to come along.
Sure. Wait, what? Gome. Invite him? That's a weird thing to say on a date.
Oh, Samir, we don't have to do everything as a date. I would like to meet some of your friends sometime. You never talk about them?
Truthfully, I've lost contact with a lot of them. My two closest friends kind of fell off the face of the earth. Scott and Damien have their own busy lives.
What about Gome? Is he not a friend?
He's a something. But yeah, I guess he's a friend.
I just want to know more about you and your world. I like you a lot and I'd like to be more serious.
What? No! Worst timing. Ever. You're all kinds of amazing, Shanae.
What do you say?
It's wonderful and I definitely... Well, you see the time.
Go ahead and answer. I'm going to look at the dresses across the way.
Gome, two things.
Yes, hello to you too.
Listen, Shanae wants to meet you. She said she wants us all to hang out together next time.
I could probably handle it for a few hours. Why are you so worked up about that? You know I'm good at keeping secrets.
There is a second thing.
Okay. And what is it?
She just asked if we could be more serious.
Oh, that does make the situation a bit complicated. What did you tell her?
Nothing. I ended up stuttering through my words trying to think up something neutral to say. Thankfully you called.
Always happy to save the day. But honestly, what are you going to tell her? Or rather, what is it that you want?
What do I want? Doesn't the idea of what I might want scare you at all? Or are you just that smug?
All right. It bothers me immensely. If I required sleep as much as a human, it would keep me up at night.
What do I do, Gome? What do I say?
What do you want?
Here she comes. Gotta go.
Are you getting hungry? I spotted a wee little coffee shop around the corner that looks like a nice spot for lunch.
Yes. I'm famished. Actually, I feel like I'm going to vomit. A week later.
That was such a wonderful show. Thank you for coming with us, Gome. It was good to finally, properly, meet you.
Yes, agreed. The show was lovely. You have quite refined tastes.
I see why Samir keeps you around.
Oh, somebody kill me, please.
Samir, we're ready to go. And do stop chewing on your nails like that or you won't even have any more.
Is the world spinning or is it just me?
Come here. Shinny is already waiting for us by the car. I can give you a tension taming massage when we get home.
Excuse me? That's going a bit far.
You're the one taking it too far. I only meant an innocent shoulder massage. What were you thinking?
Get to the car. Back to the present day. And then Shanae wanted us all to hang out more often because they hit it off so well. When did this become my life? You've been in an awfully good mood considering Shanae has been around a lot more. And not only that, doesn't it bother you when you see her kiss me?
You'd think it would, except for one small little detail that most would miss.
Oh yeah. What detail is that?
You never really kiss her back. there doesn't seem to be the same kind of enthusiasm on your end.
Are you kidding? You're seriously watching that closely? That isn't creepy or anything.
I could keep repeating myself until you're sick of hearing it, but you're forgetting, I'm not a human. I am far enough removed from your kind that I notice things most of you wouldn't.
You know, I think you're more like my kind than you think. You have to admit that being away from hell and sticking around here has practically turned you into a human. At least, I didn't think jealousy was something demons usually experienced. But you don't even seem to be going through that anymore. You're a confusing man.
I am being patient. Jealousy is an exhausting emotion.
Patient for what? You seem so sure that in the end I'm going to pick you.
You know, Samir, most would find your behavior quite awful and downright deplorable.
You started this dude, not me.
It doesn't matter how much someone likes someone else. There is a right and a wrong way to handle a situation, and honestly, I've held my tongue, but you're not handling this well.
You pressure me constantly by telling me how much you like me, you tease me, and you're always treating me like we're already in a relationship.
You came to me about the whole experiment thing.
Wow, I gotta get this. Be right back.
Yes, dodge all the hard questions. You're good at that, aren't you?
Who's avoiding questions?
Oh, you're back. I hadn't realized.
Where did Samir go?
He ran off to answer his phone. Acted like it was important.
Well, I suppose we'll just have to wait for him to get back.
Shani, we need to talk about something.
What's wrong? Is everything all right, Gomi?
No, it's not. Samir will probably kick my ass for this. But before I begin, may I have your reassurance that no matter what I say, I won't end up wearing either of our drinks?
Why would I do such a thing? I'm a bit more mature than that.
I do hope so. Samir's last girlfriend was a bit on the dangerous side.
May I hazard a guess as to what you're going to talk to me about?
I suppose. That's an odd response.
You love Samir, don't you?
Is it that obvious?
Painfully so.
You're not angry.
I'm not exactly happy either, but people can't always control how they feel. I can see it in both of you.
I suppose that saves me a bit of time to explain then.
I don't hate you, Gomi. I don't hate Samir either.
So what now? I honestly wasn't expecting things to get this far without you storming from the room.
We finish the night. We have a good time, and then you and Samir go home. At this point, this is something I need to discuss with Samir, but I suppose I have a bit of explaining to do for myself.
What do you possibly have to explain?
I had suspected this a little while ago. You two may not think the way you act is obvious, but it's very clear. Especially after that message Samir's ex sent me. So I thought it would be best that we all hang out together, just to be sure for myself. I can tell that Samir is on edge and he doesn't really want to hurt anyone, but unfortunately the way he's handling this is probably the worst way to do it.
I told him he was being Armabo Rusticai.
Sorry?
Never mind.
Regardless, Samir does have a good heart. I feel sort of guilty as well for testing him and scaring him like I did about furthering our relationship, but I only wanted to see how he would answer.
You have absolutely nothing to feel guilty for.
Well, no matter the outcome, I truly would like us all to remain friends, if that is possible.
You're not going to scream at Samir later, are you? This isn't the calm before the storm.
Look at me, Gomi. I truly am not a psychopath, okay?
All right. I believe you.
Now, the real problem here is Samir getting cold feet. He's afraid to admit his feelings for you, isn't he?
I'm not even sure anymore of his true feelings. He's so damn indecisive. This is really strange. I haven't spoken to anyone about this, let alone someone like you.
Well, whatever I am at this point, it seems like Samir needs to decide. I'll talk to him and see if I can get him to be more open with himself.
Good. I believe that's him returning as well.
Why do you get so quiet? Were you talking about me?
Come sit, Samir. I'll order another round.
What in the hell is your problem? You're good at keeping secrets, my ass.
Samir, please. There really isn't a problem.
Why are you so angry? Shani is fine. Everyone is fine.
I trusted you to keep things a secret. Things were fine as they were. Why are you so intent on forcing me to face a side of myself that I just don't want to?
You're loaded, so I'll forgive the abuse this time, but you must face yourself no matter what. Better sooner than later before you lose everyone. No one likes being slapped or verbally abused regularly.
Get out of my life.
You don't mean that.
Leave.
Samir, you're drunk. Your mind isn't entirely yours at the moment. Why don't we wait until the morning when you're back in control to discuss this?
You make my life a living hell. If you weren't here, I could have just dated Shanae like a normal person. I probably wouldn't have lost Evra, and I wouldn't have started to question my freaking sexuality.
You wouldn't have met Evra. You wouldn't have questioned anything deeper than the cans of practically radioactive liquid that were keeping you running on fumes just to get the release of the newest RPG. And if you hit me again, I promise you won't wake up until tomorrow, if you're lucky.
I'm not afraid of you. You wouldn't lay a hand on me, other than to do the obvious, which is where your brain always seems to be.
You're just angry because, rather you want to believe it or not, you like men, and it's pissing you off because you're too much of a child to accept something so damned simple.
I told you, I'm not gay. I still like women. You're just messing with my head again.
Yes, you love women so much that you don't have an ounce of enjoyment in your soul when you kiss them. Never mind the fact that you're on your second, and the first was your very first everything. Shouldn't it have been more than desperation, which is what it obviously was?
I wanted to be around Evra all the time. And yeah, she was my first everything. I'm a sad little nerd boy who couldn't even get a girl to look this way until you, a magical demon fairy, crept back into my life and poofed my fairy tale to life. Well, it's way past my midnight in this fairy tale, and you're done.
You really don't care who you hurt, do you? As long as you are able to choke down the truth that is doing more damage to you than anyone else.
I don't like hurting people. I never mean to. This wasn't what it was supposed to be. You should have left well enough alone. You shouldn't have.
I shouldn't have, what?
You shouldn't have.
Spit it out already. I shouldn't have what? I shouldn't have come back. I shouldn't have been a friend to you. I shouldn't have helped you. I shouldn't have taken care of your every trivial need for as long as I have.
You shouldn't have made me fall in love with you.
No one can make another person do that.
You did. And I've been torn between hating you for it and loving you so much that I just want to be away from you as much as possible.
You don't have to be so afraid.
I know how much harder my life is going to get, how much scarier the world will be. Never mind that you're a demon and not even a human being, which is all kinds of controversial on top of the already controversial.
Oh, come here, you drama king. You're worried about grandiose possibilities, which isn't helping you at all. You will be fine. The world will still be the same. You don't have to make an announcement or even scream it to the rooftops. You just be, and that's all there is to it.
Everyone always makes such a big deal out of it. It's always so hype up about announcing things, telling everyone you know in order to live openly, and all that. It's exhausting. And then there's my channel. I don't want to lose any fans.
Samir, you aren't even entirely sure at this point about much of anything. Have you ever thought to just relax a little and just do what your heart wants? You know, instead of fighting it. And fans are fans. You'll have more and you'll always have less at the same time. People who leave because of how you live your private life are not worth your time anyway. So pull up your big boy pants and start living the life you need to live for yourself.
I'm sorry I fought you for so long because of my own insecurities. I know you were just trying to help. As a human speaking though, it's a scary thing to realize about yourself. It takes time to undo conditioning that society programs into your head the day you're born.
Deprogramming starts now.
Wait, what are you doing? Are you going to magic it out of me or something?
No, Samir. I was being silly.
Ah, okay. Gotta get used to when you're actually magicking things or not.
I'm about to magic you to bed in a minute, so you can get some rest. You'll probably have a bit of a headache in the morning. Something amusing.
I heard the first few words and kind of panicked a little, then I realized that when you were done talking I felt kind of sad.
You really are pissed. Your moods are all over the damn place.
I just meant that maybe it would be better if I had someone to be by my side in case I get sick later.
You're expecting me to hold your hair back? Not that there's much of it.
I could really use the comfort and support of a buddy right now. You wouldn't deny me that, would you?
All right, fine. I guess I won't mind being your cuddle buddy for the night.
We can stay up until the sun rises and play Have You Ever?
Fine. So shall it be. Just don't kick me out of bed this time when you wake up because you couldn't remember the night before.
I'm pretty sure I'll remember. Besides, it's a bit different this time.
Come on. Let's get you some rest. I won't go anywhere.
Oh man, okay. So, have you ever had a pet?
A pet? Like your cat?
Yep. Just like Mr. Bigglesworth.
Just like? Samir.
What?
That's just bad.
Answer the damn question.
Alright. I did have a pet, actually. He was a little imp named Edgar who followed me around similar to a dog. He liked the taste of searing flesh best, and his favorite thing to do was run about the lake of fire outside our own little corner in hell.
Really?
No, not really. I was just teasing you.
Ugh. Always. Did I ever tell you that your laugh is actually really pleasant on the ears?
I'd already guessed. Now get some rest, Samir. No offense, but your legs are cutting off my blood supply.
Hey, what are you trying to say about me?
That you need to eat a damn cheeseburger sometime. You're practically just bones.
I can't help my metabolism.
Whatever. Personal body pillow or not, just sleep. Good night.
Good night.
Yes.
Good morning, Gomi. How's Samir?
He's as good as he can be, I suppose. Probably just a headache, but I'm letting him sleep.
Good. I was worried about you two when you left the bar last night. Samir seemed in a very bad mood.
That's putting it lightly.
Oh dear. Perhaps we shouldn't have brought it up.
I think Samir will be fine. Alcohol is a depressant after all, and Samir seems to be completely random in his handling of it.
Well, take care, okay? And I don't just mean of yourself.
Of course. As soon as I get a feel for Samir's mood, and this is assuming he won't be down for most of the day, maybe we could talk about this while sober.
Absolutely. I have to get back to work. Catch you later. There is definitely something about Gomi, but what? I'm so out of practice it's all so hazy, but there is something about his energy that isn't right. Oh dear, code blue.
I've seen this place before. But where? And when? Have you already forgotten? Forgotten what? Where are you? Of course you'd forget. Geez, it has been a while.
What are you doing?
Wait a minute. Gome, are you screwing with me?
Oh my god, Samir, I'm your conscience. You know, that little voice in the back of your head that you keep ignoring?
Prove it. What does Irmabo Rustoke mean?
Eru. What?
So maybe you're my conscience. Why show up in a dream as the person I've been trying to leave behind?
To get through to you. You know what a shock factor is, dude? It gets people's attention better.
Alright. So why are you bothering me? Oh crap.
Oh right, here comes the nausea. Maybe you should stop overdoing it.
I'll be fine. What do you want?
It's time to wake up and stop feeling sorry for yourself. You need to move on from this self-destructive behavior.
Lovely, I'm going to give myself a hard time too.
Listen, we both know the path you're going down right now isn't a good one. You're beating yourself up over something so stupid.
It's not stupid.
Well, obviously it is since I'm saying it to you, and I'm a part of you.
Just go away. You're a reminder of something I want to forget.
Fine. You want to destroy yourself over this? Go for it. But I think it's time you realized that life isn't so linear, and not everything goes as planned. Welcome to the real world. You spent way too much time cooped up in this apartment, and now that you're finally seeing the world as you should, you're nothing but a ball of anxiety. That manifests as anger, by the way. You should do something about that.
Dude, I've got a headache. Let me sleep without getting a lecture, okay?
Okay, but when you wake up I want you to get some help for yourself.
If I promise, will you go away?
Look at you. You're not the Samir you used to be. Get your sleep.
Gome. Was this all just a bad dream? One way to find out.
Oh good, you're awake. Don't feel too horrible, do you?
I think I need to talk to someone.
You've got a someone right here.
No, I mean, someone outside of all of this. Someone like one of my old friends.
If you feel that's what you need to do.
I guess I should tell you who called last night when I left you and Shanae.
Oh, so you weren't lying.
What? No!
All right. Don't get so upset in the morning.
Sorry. It was my friend Damien. I haven't seen him in a while. Not since he was in med school anyway.
Maybe it's a good idea for you to reconnect. You don't really do much outside of me and Shanae anymore.
Yeah, you're right. I'm going to try to see if he wants to meet up today.
Aren't you feeling awful from last night?
I can feel awful sitting here, moping over the jerk I've been to everyone, or I can try to go out and get a hold of myself.
That's the spirit. You should take your time today then.
Thanks for putting up with my crap.
I suppose it's more than most would do, and while I was about to hightail it out of here last night before you relented, I'm not going anywhere.
You were going to leave? For good?
Samir, people can only take so much abuse before they finally decide it isn't worth it.
I'm really sorry. I'll work on it. I never used to be that way.
Good. Now, I believe you have a friend to reconnect with.
Yes. I can come in tomorrow if you need me. Yes, no problem at all. All right. I'll speak with you later. Thank you. Bye. Sorry about that.
It's okay, dude. That thing on your ear really makes you look like a busy guy.
Besides that, are you really Samir? You look completely different from the last time I saw you.
I'm not that different, am I? You look like you've changed yourself.
I'm an intern now. This is one of my rare days off. To be honest, it's not something a lot of people would be able to handle.
So you're finally out of med school. Look at you, you're doing really well.
It seems so. Everyone is surprised I can handle all the stress, but I really don't have much to worry about besides myself. Which, speaking of, did you finally get yourself a girlfriend?
Well, yes and no.
Which one is it? Or is it one of those complicated things you see on Facebook that doesn't really make any sense?
Honestly, I don't know at this point. She hasn't said anything in particular, but it's definitely on its way out.
Oh man, she isn't one of those manipulative types, is she?
Definitely not. Been there and done that. More like, I have been the manipulative one.
Damn, Samir, what have you gotten yourself into? You were this lonely nerdy guy building a YouTube channel, and now you're all kinds of messed up from who I used to know by the sound of it. And the looks.
Hey, I'm still me, somewhere in here. But anyway, you want the short version or the long version?
I got all day, especially for an old friend.
Okay, so long story short. So, that's everything.
You weren't kidding when you said you'd been through a lot. Although I do remember the crap you were going through the last time we talked. I still don't know if I want to believe all of that, but it sounds like you've got your problems cut out for you.
I've been a real jerk. I don't know when it changed. Maybe I just unconsciously got full of myself because I finally felt good about my appearance, and it got to my head after my first girlfriend.
Even though this guy set you up with a girl, you don't have to go after the very first person who shows interest in you. It takes time to figure out who you work best with, you know? Then again, I think you already know who you work best with. You're just not wanting to admit it. Seems this Shinee is on board too.
I'm working on it. But hey, I don't want you to feel like you have to be my counselor right now. Let's go have some fun. I haven't seen you in a while, and I don't want it to all just be about me or drama.
Sounds good, Samir. But hey, don't be so hard on this Gome guy, okay? It sounds like he's being more patient with you than most people would. And it sounds like that's who you're ultimately wanting to end up with anyway.
Maybe. But let's go do something that doesn't involve complicated relationship stuff.
Don't get so down. Everything is going to turn out all right.
Okay, I believe you. Want to go to the arcade?
Samir, you want me to walk in a place like that dressed like this? We're getting older now.
Hey man, video games are still part of my career, and we're only 23.
All right. To the arcade then. But remember that you'll never beat my House of the Dead score if that machine is even still there.
Video opportunity. That way I'll have it on record and on my YouTube if and when I do.
What in the hell is wrong with me? Why am I so paranoid? Was that an elevator?
What is it? I'm busy.
We're having a bit of a problem on level 9.
Level 9 is trivial. I told you to only contact me with problems involving the first 3 levels. Anything beyond that can solve itself.
Forgive me, sir, but this soul insists he is the reincarnation of Dante, and refuses to progress lest we hear his recitation of Inferno.
Let him rot in purgatory then. I don't have time for such ridiculous farces.
Another one? They're still doing that?
I'm afraid so. It becomes monotonous after a while, honestly. Other than that, things get rather boring.
Is that why you called me here? And with a flourish as well. Was that your idea of a sense of humor? Odd for you.
I do amuse myself sometimes, but if we're being honest, maybe I missed you.
You? Missed me? Why me? I'm nothing special.
I wasn't serious, Gome. What are you doing?
Currently I'm wondering why my evening was interrupted.
You're getting very informal with your speech. I don't know if I like you being away for so long. It's making your head soft.
Forgive me, I have been dealing with a lot.
Yes, you have been, haven't you? Or perhaps you're just dealing with one thing in particular that you can't seem to shake?
You're the one who banished me to live as a human for a year. How could that have not had an effect on me?
A year for a demon is a simple blip in a human sense. It's happened before with others. You just seem to be vulnerable to the stupidity.
What do you want me to do then? Return. I hardly think hell is going to go into chaos without my presence.
You're correct there, it won't. If it was someone like Lucifer, or Abaddon, then I would worry. However, it is getting to the point where you need to make the ultimate decision. I don't offer this to many, but I seem to go too easy on you. Make your choice.
What decision am I supposed to be making?
You honestly expect to be able to continue your work as the demon trickster Gomei after having been so tainted? You're barely even fit to call yourself a demon anymore. Getting involved in human drama, falling in love, becoming possessive? Gomei, this is embarrassing.
Wait, Father, it doesn't have to be like this. Why can't we just coexist as we are?
Because you're too far gone. Can you honestly tell me you'd be able to continue to do what started all of this? Could you enter another human's life and cause discord without feeling guilty, or without wondering what Samir would think?
Alright, so what? Why can't I still come home when I need to? Why can't I just be assigned other tasks?
That's not the way this works and you know it. If you were more respectable on the hierarchy we may be able to talk, but you are not a fallen, nor are you a prince or a king. You are just Gomei. So make your choice.
Can't I have more time? I don't even know if staying up there will be worth it.
You have 1 human week to make your decision. You choose Summer or you choose Hell. There is no in-between and no compromise. I truly do not care which you choose, but we need to move on. I need to know whether you're off the roster or not.
Alright. A week. I will try to work things out by then and I will be back to you with my answer.
Before you go, do know this. A demon banished from Hell may retain his immortality, but as the years go on your magic will become more and more useless until you are a demon with nothing more than the title itself. So keep that in mind. Continue as a demon, or continue on as an immortal with a, quite frankly, boring eternity ahead of him.
I've got a lot of thinking to do.
Right, you do. I release you for now.
Samir, you'd better be worth it.
So what's with all of this all of a sudden?
Well, since you seem to be a man of 1 too many repressed emotions.
Hey now.
And you have trouble giving a serious answer to pretty much anything, I figured a change of scenery might help matters.
What are you trying to do? Get a confession out of me or something?
Well, I realize that's going to be near impossible with you.
Gomei, I've told you I need some time to process everything. I've been dealing with a lot mentally for the past few days.
You've also completely stopped talking to Shani. What's going on with that?
We're not dating anymore. Why should we keep talking?
Oh, I don't know. A thing called platonic friendship.
First you're all jealous over me talking to women, and now you're trying to get me to be friends with the girl I dated. You're really confusing.
I'm just trying to do what is best for you. You rarely speak with your friends, the very few if any that you do keep. But that aside, I do have something important to discuss with you.
What's wrong? Is everything okay?
What are your true feelings for me?
How many times do I have to tell you that I need time to figure that out?
You've had nothing but time, and I really need to know.
You're always trying to push me one way or another. Why can't you just be patient with me? I've already admitted that I like you, but I'm just not used to any of this. How do I know it isn't just some weird reaction to realizing I like guys, and it'll eventually wear off?
So I'm basically that guy in the situation where you go for the first one that shows feelings for you?
I don't know. It's why I want to figure this out, okay? I promise I'll have a more solid answer for you soon.
Some of us don't have all the time in the world.
What's that supposed to mean? You got somewhere else to be?
Well, not exactly at this moment.
You're not telling me something.
Sorry, Samir. I'll be right back.
Wait a minute! He's going to drive me even more insane than I already am.
Hello, Gomei.
Shani, as much of a joy as it is to hear from you, I'm afraid I'm a bit busy at the moment.
I apologize for interrupting you, but could we meet somewhere to talk? Without Samir?
Maybe tomorrow. Why?
Tomorrow then. I'll meet you at the cafe.
What was that about? Either way, it doesn't matter. If I can't get Samir to be honest with me by the end of the week, then I might as well start planning my eternity back in hell.
I hope I'm right about all of this.
So, what did you need to talk to me about?
Oh boy, how to say this without sounding completely mental.
Is it really that serious?
I know what you are.
Besides, a bit confused.
Don't play games. I'm able to sense this sort of thing.
So what is it that you think I am? Besides, a moron in an unrequited relationship with another moron.
You're a demon, aren't you?
How did you figure it out? Did he tell you? Oh, lovely. Don't tell me you're one of those intellectual sorts that knows a binding spell or two, or an exorcism.
That depends. Should I need one or the other?
Okay, so you're a medium. Whatever. Is that why you called me here? Are you going to banish me to hell where I belong? Well, go ahead. I'm headed there soon anyway.
What about Samir? You seem attached to him, so he must be why you're here to begin with.
Oh, good lord in hell. How many times do I have to remember the travesty?
What travesty? What did you do to Samir?
Oh, well. What's once more for old time's sake? Long story short. And now we're here. Making me realize once again how much of a fool I've been to even meddle with a human in the first place.
Oh my, that is a travesty. I don't know who to feel more sorry for.
At least you haven't pulled out a rosary and splashed me with holy water.
I won't lie, I was very concerned for a short while. I did consider bringing you here today to be rid of you because I suspected you had been manipulating Samir.
But yet you speak in past tense. So I take it your mind has been changed.
I suppose it has. You don't really hear about demons as if they had feelings, like humans do, so to sympathize with one feels quite strange.
You make it sound as if I'm something with little value.
I have learned better than that just now, obviously. You can't be cross with me for what I've been brought up to believe.
I suppose not. But to be entirely honest with you, I wouldn't have minded being banished back to hell again. I already feel like this realm is much worse. I fail to see what's so funny.
I can't believe that I'm about to help a demon, but it sounds like you're in quite a predicament.
That's putting it lightly.
The fact that you would risk this much for a human certainly is telling of your true nature and your true intentions. Rather demon or human, you have a good heart, and a good heart always deserves happiness.
Nothing can be done. I have a few days left to figure out what I need to do, and I fear I've only wasted my time.
Don't give up yet. I've got a plan.
How ironic this is, my desire to be the total opposite of what I had wanted only a few years previous. I feel as if my very existence itself is something to be scorned no matter what realm I choose to occupy. Is the matter too far out of hand now? Can I no longer exist anywhere without this dull pain that throbs within my chest, behind this very flesh that I falsely claim to be my own? I am not human, although I have come to live as one. Dare I even say that I wish to have this flesh stripped from these bones, bit by bit, until I no longer can feel that dull and sickening pain? Why can't I just choose the quiet insanity of the void? This is only going to accomplish nothing.
Why all the creepy, weird demon coming from the shadows stuff? And where's Shanae?
she isn't coming.
Okay, so, what's going on?
Do you remember last year when you arrived here to meet me, despite your misgivings?
Yeah. I remember waiting for the train and thinking I'd made a huge mistake.
I'm sure you retain that feeling to this day, don't you?
Sometimes.
Sometimes.
Is there a point in any of this right now?
I'm leaving.
Wait, whoa, what? Where's this coming from all of a sudden? Leaving? Why?
I can't stay here and wait forever for you. I've realized I've overstayed my welcome and basically pressured you into a lot of things that you're just not ready for. I'm not sure you'll ever be ready.
I thought we were working things out, having a good time together.
I've been given a choice, Samir. Today is the day that I have decided to make it since you can't make yours.
What choice? You mean you can't stay here?
I can, but that would mean giving up everything that I existed for in the past. That would require giving up everything for you. But my time is running short and I have spent much too long hoping you'd finally come to some sort of conclusion.
You were going to give up everything for me?
Yes, I was. But then I realized that I couldn't possibly tell you the truth or your answer may not be sincere. I had hoped you'd answer me honestly. Over the past week I'd been trying to get some sort of confession from you, rather it be good or bad.
Wait, this is nuts. Why couldn't you just be honest? And now you're just going to leave and I'm going to be here alone with these feelings. What if I miss you too much? Will I ever see you again?
I'm afraid not. When I return, I will never make contact with you in any way ever again.
Gome.
I've got a schedule to keep, as unfortunate as that is. So I guess this is goodbye, Samir.
No, wait.
Lucifer.
Yes, sir.
Take Gome off the roster.
You mean?
Obviously. Now, let's get moving with the rest of eternity, alright?
Gome. I love you.
Keep our pistols near.
neighbors frail and thin as they disappear. Let the chaos come. Let our houses freeze. The lights will all go out, but we'll finally see. Something I do.
looking down the sights. Your heart is worn and the seams are torn, and they've given you a reason to fight. And you're not gonna take what they've got to give, and you're not gonna let them take your will to live, because they've taken enough and you've given them all you can give, and luck won't save them tonight. They're giving you a reason to fight. The storms you've been chasing about to rain down tonight. And all the pain you've been facing about to come into the light. Your hands upon dead man's gun, and you're looking down the sights. Your heart is worn and the seams are torn, and they've given you a reason to fight. And you're not gonna take what they've got to give, and you're not gonna let them take your will to live, because they've taken enough and you've given them all you can give, and luck won't save them tonight. They're giving you a reason to fight.
Put your head hang low. You've seen the darkest skies I know. Let your heart run child like horses in the wild. So take my hand and hold me.
At the bottom of my heart, ooh, me, oh my. If we open our eyes, I think we're both gonna